All right, I want to talk with you about perpendicular lines in this video. So I've got the equation here, y is equal to 2x minus 3. And I want to look into what kind of line would we have that would be perpendicular to this. So you may think that, well, parallel lines have the same slope. So obviously, if I'm going to have a perpendicular line here, it's going to have to be something that's going to meet here like this in order to meet at a 90 degree angle. So my slope is obviously has to be negative if my first slope is positive. So you may think that, well, if my slope in my first line is positive 2, the slope on my second line has got to be negative 2. So let's see what happens with this. So y is equal to negative 2x. And let's just go plus 3. We'll keep it at that same idea of 3. So you'll notice here that it does intersect, but this angle right here is not a 90 degree angle. It does not meet at a right angle. So my slope being negative helps, but it does not make it a perpendicular line, because remember, the idea of perpendicular means that the angles are going to meet at a right angle, 90 degrees. So negative slope helps, but it does not make it a 90 degree angle. So the thing that we have to have here, and I'm going to put in the equation of the line that is perpendicular. All right, so you'll notice here that I have now this green line that also has a y-intercept of 3. My slope is negative 1/2. And these two lines, the red line and the green line, now do meet at a 90 degree angle. So when I sketch this in here, you'll see that, yeah, that is a square. We can draw that there, and it is a 90 degree angle. So what we have to do is we have to look at our two lines, and I'm going to erase the blue one since that doesn't matter to us. And the thing that is important here, let's take a look at what we've got. The first line has a slope of 2 and a y-intercept of negative 3. The second line has a slope of negative 1/2 and a y-intercept of positive 3. So take a minute and consider those two lines and think about what is important about those things and how can you identify the fact that they're perpendicular. What is it about the slope and the y-intercept that you can look at to identify that they're perpendicular? And I am going to pause this and put two other lines on the graph and then also show the slope and the intercept, and we'll see if your hypothesis is correct or not. So I'm going to pause and put my other lines on the graph. All right, I am back, and you will now notice that I have the purple line here and the orange line, and those two lines, if you look closely at them, you will notice that they are indeed meeting at a right angle, so they are perpendicular right there. And when we look at our slopes, we realize the slope of the first equation, y is equal to 2/5 x, the slope is 2/5. The y-intercept is 0. The second line, the slope is negative 5/2, and the y-intercept is negative 1. So now that you have that information, is the hypothesis that you made correct? Hopefully what you noticed is that the idea of lines that are perpendicular, the slopes have a special relationship. The first line, the slope is 2. The second line that's perpendicular, the slope is negative 1/2. So it's opposite signs, positive and negative, and also reciprocals. 2, the reciprocal of 2, which remember is really the fraction 2/1. The reciprocal of 2/1 is 1/2. So the relationship between two lines that are perpendicular is that the slopes are negative reciprocals of each other. So the second one, slope is positive 2/5, and then we have to take the opposite because they have to be opposites in order to intersect in a perpendicular way. And then also the reciprocal of 2/5 is 5/2. So 2/5 is one slope, negative 5 over 2 is the other slope. So the big idea for perpendicular lines is that the slopes have to be opposite reciprocals of each other. So if I were to tell you that your slope of your original line is negative 3, what is the slope of the line that is perpendicular to that? Well, it's got to be opposite of negative 3, so it's got to be positive. And then the reciprocal of negative 3 is the flip of this fraction, 3 over 1. So the flip of the fraction 3 over 1 is 1/3. So it's positive because it's the opposite sign, and then it's the flip of that fraction or the reciprocal of that fraction. So those two slopes would give you lines that are perpendicular to each other. One last thing that I want to look at is what happens when you have a vertical line and a horizontal line with the slopes. So I'm going to put in my equation of a vertical line and a horizontal line and erase these other ones. So for this, if I have the equation y is equal to 3, that is a horizontal line. And then I have the other equation, x is equal to, let's say, 2, that is a vertical line. And you will notice that those two lines do indeed meet here at a right angle, so they are perpendicular, but the slopes don't quite fit our definition. The slope of this horizontal line is 0. It's a 0 slope for a horizontal line. The slope of this vertical line, though, is undefined. So we can't say specifically that they're opposite reciprocals of each other, but we can make sense of how that works and why the slope of this vertical line has to be undefined if the slope of the original line is 0. Because using our rule that says the slopes are opposite reciprocals, well, this 0 is really the fraction 0 over 1 or 0 over whatever number you want to imagine is down there, and the reciprocal of that would be 1 over 0. And it would have to be negative, right? If the two lines are going to be perpendicular. But this causes us a problem, 1 divided by 0. There is no answer to that. If we tried to do it with long division, 1 divided by 0, well, it can't be 0 because 0 times 0 is 0, not 1. It can't be 1 because 1 times 0 is 0, not 1. So there is not an answer to this. We can't do it. That's where it becomes undefined. So this is one of those special cases that you just kind of have to commit to memory, realizing that the slope of a horizontal line is 0, the slope of a vertical line is undefined, and a horizontal and vertical line do indeed meet at a 90-degree angle, so they are perpendicular.